Welcome to Keep It Simple Screenprinter, part two of our how to use the Kolormatrix exposure calculator to determine the ideal exposure time. We're going to pre-wet down. The inside. And we're going to come to the outside. Softening of the screen. You can see we have a little bit of inkjet residue with the ink transfer and anything else. It is a damp, cool day here in Atlanta. The exposure calculator was just printed about half hour ago. The emulsion did absorb a little bit of ink, but it will come out during the developing process. I'm going to use the pressure washer to speed things up. I'm going to keep the tip of the pressure washer outside the booth, as I don't want to risk blowing out my detail. Relatively consistent speed. I'm keeping a relatively consistent distance to make sure that I cover the entire area. I don't want to focus in on any one area. I want to give the areas all the same amount of time I'm under pressure, so they have the same amount of time to develop during the process. Exposure. If you want to come forward, take a look. We'll notice here, line 10 is our highest exposure time. We take the row and we multiply it by the number of time units. We were doing 5-second exposures. So we got 5 seconds, 10, 15, 20, 25. So up here at approximately 50 seconds, you see that we've lost all of our thin lines. We've lost all of our reverse half tones up here. And that we come down here to the other end to the minimal amount of time. And here, and you'll see that our small half tones have all washed out on there. So as we look at the times in here, and we look at row number 2, even the finest text, both reverse and standard, our half tones are all there. Even our finest line is here. So we come up to row 3, we can start to see that we're starting to lose some, and we're starting to lose some of our reverse dots here. So row 2 is our ideal exposure time. So for this mesh count, which we are using here, is 180 mesh with the CBX 7500 emulsion with the Vastex E200 exposure unit. Row 2 is the best exposure unit. We were most of exposure time. We were at 5 seconds level, so 10 seconds is the ideal exposure time for this mesh. I would do this over for each mesh count, and if I'm using different emulsions, I would also do it for my different emulsions, and then you will get perfect exposure every time. Hopefully you found this helpful. If you did, please like and share, and as always, thanks for watching.